Okay, so I'm back in America, and while I'm here, I wanted to just do a quick overview of how things are done here, just standard practice for weatherization, to show some of the things that we could learn in Australia to improve, like really cost-effective improvements, like standard air sealing, standard blower door test to find leaks, and to document improvements. Really cheap, cost-effective stuff that really gets energy savings and comfort improvements for homeowners.
My name's Kermit Eggsware. I'm an inspector for Bode Energy Management, and I oversee weatherization companies throughout Western Massachusetts. I do quality assurance, in-process inspections, post-inspections, and oversee HEAs. Normally on a daily basis, as you see here, we're in Westboro. I meet with the crews and I review the spec, answer any questions and concerns the homeowners have, help the crews identify thermal boundary issues, identify any roadblocks, and basically just kind of measure and go over everything, make sure everything's safe, they're following standards, and just help them navigate their way through. Today we had a basic attic, the crews cross batting, air sealing penetrations, they added prop vents to have proper ventilation. But normally on a daily basis, it can be knee walls, crawl spaces, basements, exterior, interior. There's a mixture of walls, different areas throughout the home. But my job is really to make sure the customer is getting the proper savings and everything's done adequately to the program standards. Most crews know me. I've been doing this about 7 years. I know construction. I have a thorough background, you know, certifications, licenses throughout a variety of homes, commercial, residential. Part of my job is to stop by every day and kind of just check on everything and make sure it's a smooth operation and meet the program statutes.
All right, here I am in the first attic, and there's work hasn't started yet. So there's some things that we can see. Some stuff is just standard practice before they even start work. So one is they've, just like Australia, they've removed the insulation, which was in here before. They're going to use loose fill insulation here. So they're going to spray with a system blown cellulose insulation, which is paper fiber insulation.
It's not itchy. It's eco-friendly, right? No breathing problems, no fiberglass in it.
But before they do that, they do some pretty key things. So one of them is they're going to use make sure that there's proper venting for the roof, because they don't want the roof to suffer moisture damage. So at the eaves, they call them vent baffles. They're things that allow air to come up over the insulation, make sure that the roof surface is ventilated and not blocked by insulation. That's something I haven't seen yet in Australia. So one thing that's pretty standard to consider is venting. So here there's a gable vent on the end of the wall here. And then they also check that there's venting at the roof here. So this, they call this a ridge vent. So that's making sure they have both high and low, an inlet and an outlet for the air to come in to keep the roof cool and to remove any condensation that comes into the roof. So that's one thing. Venting is very, very important for moisture management in a retrofit like this. So this home has gone all electric, but still this chimney, which used to be for the fossil fuel burning heating system, no longer in use. Nevertheless, they need to treat the area around the chimney as if it is combustible. So they need to use proper flashing to protect this from insulation. Make sure that if they ever did decide to use a heating system, fossil fuel heating system, this would still be safe, fire safe. Another thing that's different here that you don't see in Australia is this fan here. These are pretty common in New England, northeast US. This is a fan that constantly draws air out. This is piped all the way down to the basement, and it goes down to the foundation, and it's putting negative pressure on the foundation to suck any soil gases from the foundation. Because here in the northeast US, there's radon in some of the rocks, depending on the house. There might be radioactive radon gas in the rocks, and they need to suck that out because radon is a cancer risk. So that's something luckily is not common in Australia, but it has to be considered here.
One thing we've commented on here is that at some point there was a bathroom renovation. You can see new plasterboard there. And you can see we all commented how this was not very good ductwork and it wasn't sealed at the exterior. So they're going to seal there. They're going to seal at the ceiling level there to make sure no humid air from the bathroom is getting up into this roof space, because that will cause harm. So one thing that's absolutely standard for any insulation job is to do some air sealing before they start insulating. So this here is the top plate here, the top of this wall. So if air gets into the wall from the bottom of the wall or from any penetration, screw holes, things like that, or from plumbing penetrations below, that air will come out of this hole here and then bring the moisture with it and cause not just energy loss, but possible moisture problems. So every top plate in the whole attic, the whole roof space gets sealed, and every penetration here gets sealed with expanding foam to seal all these gaps along, and that goes the length of the entire roof space. Every top plate between all the rooms gets sealed, and that goes for the top plates at the walls along the exterior as well. They have a rule that if it's accessible, it has to be sealed. So there's going to be a whole lot of air sealing before they even start with the insulation up here.
Kermit, tell me what you're seeing here.
So right here, as you look down, once she places a camera down low, the crew air sealed the top plates, which is part of the air sealing. But you see the remnants of the black on the loose fiberglass bat right here. These are normally signs of air leakage coming through. This bat was placed here prior to air sealing. Anytime you see a lot of this, it gives you signs that this is the air leakage coming out of, you know, any penetrations or gaps or voids in the attic floor.
And so air sealing all the top plates is standard before insulation?
Yes. Best practice is to air seal all penetration gaps, wet walls, sealing the bat fans, chimneys, prior to adding open blow cellulose.
So all this insulation here, they lifted all this insulation and they've done all this air sealing along all the top plates here.
Yep.
There's another one. So every single top plate here has been air sealed before they add any more insulation?
Correct. They have to air seal all top plates. It's part of the program rules and regulations.
Awesome.
To stop air leakage.
And so you can see the dust traces, that's showing just
how much air was coming out of just this small little area. It's kind of a sign.
Just from those cracks in the top plates.
Correct.
What look like close fitting timber boards there.
Yeah.
It's letting air leak for its whole life. So this house is how old? Maybe she said maybe 30 years old?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And that's how much air leakage gathers over 30 years. And so you're dealing with this now, and it's going to pay itself back long term.
Yep. And also a lot of those gaps over time with not having the adequate insulation can cause moisture issues, right? The hot air, cold air collides in the wintertime. And then you end up getting the frost or the moisture or the condensation buildup on the roof decking. As of here, it's pretty hot and dry, so there's no effect. But underneath the floor, that's high cost rising in our bill. You know, heat loss, central air, that's something to look for. And we try to make sure we always air seal all top plates. Same thing, insulation around duct boots, you'll probably find the same. Other penetrations that get sealed is duct boots there. If you take a closer look, you'll see more wall cavities and voids.
Yeah.
There probably was fiberglass batting over here with traces and remnants that got moved around.
But
that is best practice.
Okay.
In the Mass Save program in Massachusetts.
So this is another example, you said?
Yep, another example. You can see the black dust that builds up on the fibers coming from the penetration around from the ductwork. As you can see right here. You know, it's light because they moved it around, but you know, this is just a little showing of that top right there not being sealed properly.
It's the leak around the ductwork penetration there leaves dust traces as the air leaks out.
Yep.
Standard to seal it, right?
Correct.
So a lot of this stuff you're saying is it's someone's quality control, like yes or no, did you do it right or not? But it's also just a lot of training, right?
Correct.
You're talking about doing the venting for the eaves properly, so it could be improved. And so it's not like they're not gonna get paid, but you're just telling them here's how you could make it better.
Yep. Basically, part of my job is quality assurance. And what I do is, like, you know, for instance, we just discussed here, you know, it looks vented properly. But if you come over here and you move this fiberglass, there's a gap from the existing chute vent or prop vent, as we call them. And the air that's coming from the continuous soffit actually stops there. So with the fiberglass being placed in the open below, you're actually blocking the ventilation long term. If a lot of these weren't installed properly, you know, might be a ventilation problem.
Yeah.
So that's one catch that I just caught, to make sure that it is venting properly and have the continuous airflow.
Yep.
So they will be adjusting that and hitting the exterior top plates.
All right. And so another quick one. This is, there's some there's ductwork up here in the attic, and you can see, what have they done here?
So here, part of the program standards is duct sealing any seams, joints. These are manufactured in the factory, so there's more than likely another seam on the bottom corner on this side. So you're supposed to hit all seams, bends where the tongue and groove meets, or we call these S-locks or S-bars, where these lock in. And you see all that trying to make the system more efficient, helping with the cost of heating and cooling.
Yep.
Because if a system has, you know, 50% leaks, 50% operational, if you can seal most of these, you're helping, you know, the homeowner and the system.
Yep.
The life of it will last a lot longer.
And so we don't see this much in Australia, but you've got duct mastic here, which is a water-based goo that you just smear on the crack there. You don't mess around with the tapes. A lot of tapes.
Yep.
Anymore.
Yep. So here we do. If it's already taped, there is a rated tape. If it was taped already, with the rated tape which has mastic on it, it wouldn't be eligible. In this case, they are going to mastic this, which hardens its water base. And then after, the only tapes they will be using is the FSK tape, which is rated.
Yep.
And then they should be stapling all these joints back to factory when they're done.
Okay.
So they still have to open this up and hit, you know, the top, call it the top left and the bottom right.
Yep.
Because it's crimped as an L, and those are the two main seams on most ductwork, plus every seam that joints.
And then you can see on the insulation, the traces of air leakage from the ducts, right?
Correct.
Yeah, so that's duct leakage right there.
Yep. That's just the dust and the airflow coming out from, more than likely, this was a joint right here where they bent it. There's, you know, was previous seams and pinholes there, which the air was flowing out of.
Yep.
Same thing consistent here. You know, you see how that's loose, right? Yes, we're not tugging on it, but if I can tug on it, there is airflow coming out of here. These register boots stick on, but it's always best practice to seal here and on the floor as well.
Yep.
Which is part of all of duct sealing.
Okay. So these guys have done a pretty good job air sealing along the wall.
Yep.
Tops.
Yeah, here. They did an efficient job. As you see, they hit the main runner down the whole entire attic, and any plates that came off, they hit all the way.
Okay.
The gun was adjusted properly.
And you can see some old traces of dust on some of the fiberglass from where the air was going up through. Yep. Before. Yep. Yeah, that one's got a lot of dirt on it. So there must have been a lot of air going through that over the years. So we've got bathroom underneath, and that's a fan coming up from there. And we got ductwork going here.
Yep.
And you said
the old vent right here, as you can see, was not properly venting. So the condensation was building up, colliding with the hot air or cold air, depending on the season, which started building what we call MLS, which is like a mold-like substance, which over time, you know, could end up on your roof decking, floor. So adding insulated hose here and sealing that bath fan and having it properly vented out will stop that.
Interesting. So insulated hose would keep that surface warm. So the warm, humid air would make it all the way out without cooling down to the point where it condenses.
Yep.
That's the idea?
Yep. And then at the end, they put a loop. So any moisture that was traveling back down cannot make it back down into the bathroom. So
okay.
There is a loop at the end.
So this bath fan hasn't been sealed yet, so that's one thing that they need to finish yet, right?
Correct. It's part of the program. Air
seal it from the top. And again, you can see the traces of dust on the insulation long-term, where the air leakage leaves its trace as it goes. So here we have some ductwork going through ceiling plane here. If there's a chase next to the ductwork, they got to flash this and seal it up from above, because there's that big gap between the ductwork and the ceiling plane. And you can see over the many years how dirty this fiberglass gets
from all the air that's passing through.
So you guys do a blower door test before and after, and you said it doesn't take a lot of time to do it. And does it lead to savings?
Yes, it does. It does lead to savings. You can actually, when we're doing the work, you can actually feel how quick the work is you can tell how quick our insulation is treating someone's home because of how hot it gets in that little area where we're working at, either the attic or knee wall.
So the exact number you get on the blower door doesn't matter as much as noticing some savings, right?
Exactly.
Cool. So you guys do the air sealing. You've already done some air sealing up in the attic here. Are you done?
Yes. For the air sealing portion in the attic, we're done. We just got to do some air seal in the basement. But as of right now, in the attic, we just got to do a little bit more duct seal, and that's pretty much it.
Cool.
Yeah.
So Kermit, you're doing quality control on the work that's been done. And you said this is your toolkit?
Yep. So we have, for the BPI 1200 standards, this is for a spillage smoker test, make sure there's no leaks coming out of the system.
Yep.
I have infrared camera to check walls when the temperatures are adequate. I have a CO detector to make sure the home is safe before entering. We have a gas detector to detect any gas leaks. Have a voltage reader, come across any old wiring or knob and tube, or splice wires or junction boxes. This is actually the camera that goes here. And then underneath here, there's extra tools, carry extra zip ties. Each bath fan, you're supposed to have one on the inlet and one on the outlet. So to the roof, you should have a zip tie and one after you connect the insulated hose. We carry zip ties just in case on a post or in process inspection, the crew has not done it. And in order to make sure it's done adequately, we sometimes have to install those.
Zip tie to make sure that when the duct tape fails,
yep,
that the zip tie will still hold it.
Yep.
So it doesn't disconnect. And you also have a blower door in your truck.
Yep, blower door, Tyvek tape, drills, metal tape, probe sticks to test insulation depth, extra painter's tape, a telescope, another way of testing spillage and draft on the mirror. We have bits to drill into the system just in case we have to drill a test hole adequately. When we're testing walls, we carry putty also to check the wall bases. And then my system, and then on my back seat, I have my blower door bag, combustion safety, which is my back rack, and my manometer.
All right, so this duct going up here
was previously vented out.
Yeah.
But due to it being an old plastic corrugated hose, not insulated, the crew is going to change it with a insulated bath fan hose.
Because you want the hose to be warm so that you don't get condensation in it. And all the moisture that's extracting, you want it to go outside, not collect on the duct.
Yep, and that's an R4.
You can see all the things they've air sealed there here. They've done a lot of air sealing.
All the traces of the air leakage. Remove it all. It's been all air sealed. Yep, properly air sealed. Nice and clean beads, 1-inch beads. Nothing missed.
Everywhere, nothing missed.
Properly spaced.